There it is, folks. Motherfucking Fruit Loops. Sent in from a fan. I told him I'd eat them for him. Because I have no shame. Apparently this guy likes to watch people eat Fruit Loops. I do want to apologize. I don't have a gaping butthole to put them in and eat them out of. But Jordan...
Hey, but we are looking for volunteers.
Yeah, we are looking for volunteers. So... I'm going to get this thing started right
call
here.
A, call the hotline.
All right.
Without, now, when you eat your cereal, do you just eat it like right now when it's still crispy?
I like to get a little soggy.
Let it sit for a minute? You know?
I like it to get a little soggy, but not like too soggy.
Everybody
you know?
Has different techniques.
I like it to be absorbed, you know?
Yes.
Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, the man on the cameras, Mr. Lover Slope and Dusty B.,
What's going on? What's up?
Man, I'm about to devour some Fruit Loops.
Do it, man.
For a fan. I'm going to do it.
They look tasty.
The sad thing is I just ate.
You did.
Yeah. So.
You don't look like you turned down a meal.
Fuck no. Look at me. I wouldn't turn down two meals. Fuck. The other voice you're hearing on the microphone tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is... You know, I can't even think of anything... Awesome to say about this guy because I've already said it so many times. The only thing I can say is here's Cuckboy Bruce Leonard.
Yeah, it's cuck season.
Cuck season.
Yeah.
Bruce.
I think someone called me a cuck earlier. I think
on Facebook.
Like, yeah, it's pretty much.
Man,
I called you a cuck.
Pretty much everyday thing.
Hey, every time I'm on like YouTube,
you're
or something,
used to it now.
Their insult playbook is like a flashcard. It's just they got like five things they say, and that's it.
Front and back.
Yeah.
It's got a word on one side and like the sentence
funny.
To use
that's why
on
I think
the
it's
other.
Funny. It's like if you talk to these people, they all think that they're like revolutionary and like, you know, free thinkers or whatever. And they all talk the same, like fucking sheep. It's like if you're all so fucking like original and free thinking, like why are y'all. Like, they have like five words that they use.
Was it like cuck? Motherfucker.
They'll call you cuck.
Jew.
Yeah,
Jew.
They'll call you cuck.
Jew.
Cuck, faggot, Jew, a communist, or then they'll call you a communist Jew.
Like, they sound like they need to like. They sound like Cartman, basically. Because those are like
they
Cartman
need to go to
the
thesaurus,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
Yes, that's what I'm always like. They're always, and I've talked to 1,000 of these guys, and they all talk the same. It's just fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
It's like brainwashing 101. Like, you know, they all go through this brainwashing course, and when they come out the end, they all come out. They hate
the
minorities,
same.
And they know five insults.
Yeah,
it's like that's the
true.
End of it.
Got to keep now, it simple.
Yeah, definitely got to keep it simple. Like eating a bowl of Fruit Loops. You know what I'm saying? Keep it simple.
Yeah.
But anyway, the other voice you guys are hearing on the mic tonight. I don't know if Dusty's already cut to him or not. Yes,
I have a couple times.
He already has. It's all good though. Legendary local comedian here. I guess, is it cool to call you a local comedian?
Cool to call me legendary?
Well, yeah.
So you used to call me all the time. It's the same thing. Like, what?
Legendary is like a good thing to call somebody, I think.
That's some big shoes
what you
there,
call
buddy.
Yeah. Any of us.
Well, you know what they say
40.
About a guy with big shoes.
Yeah, it is true, but that's what I'm true. Saying, I don't know if. What make you legendary?
I mean, you're a well-known comedian in the area here. I mean, you've toured like nationwide, right?
Yeah.
See, I'm actually legendary in my book.
Hey, fuck, thanks, man.
I didn't even fucking went across the Mississippi, man. You know, farthest I went's like fucking Louisville. No, I went to Texas. I did cross the Mississippi. I take that back.
Hey, man, thanks.
But
man.
That's neither here nor there. Ladies and gentlemen, Tyrone Hawkins. Hey, in the building.
I'm in the building.
You want some of these Fruit Loops, bro?
Oh no, I'm cool, man. I'm lactose intolerant.
Really?
You know,
mm-hmm.
It's funny you mentioned that.
Should have told that chick to try to suck your dick for $2.50. She probably would have raised the price then.
She probably would have said, well, I don't have, don't need no milk.
Tell us about
$2.50.
Tell us about that again. You went over to Bruce's house.
Oh,
you're
man.
At the gas station.
Yeah, I got propositioned at the United Dairy Farmers. Of all the place, the capital of lactose production in Cincinnati. This is a crazy world, ain't it?
What were you buying at UDF?
I just got some orange juice. What happened was my GPS was flexing. So it just kept telling me how to it was wouldn't let me get to your house, and so I pulled over because I don't text and drive, you know.
Right.
So I pull over, go in and get my little orange juice and get back before I can get to the back truck. Sir, 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 sir.
And you instantly knew from the very first time you heard, sir.
Here's one of them $2.50.
Yeah, it's my lucky day.
Yeah, she offered to
go to work.
Go to work, yeah. $2.50. That was her number. She came up with that.
She came up with $2.50.
She just looked up at the gas sign. That's what she saw. It's like, I'll do it for $2.49.
$2.49.9.
On pump three.
Let's just make it $2.50. I don't want to have to do math.
On pump three. That was funny. That's a good tag there, buddy. I'd like to thank you guys for 3 minutes of comedy for 2017. Start my set off.
That's awesome.
See how long I can milk this one out.
I like the puns, man. Yeah. That's awesome.
That's what makes it funny. The puns.
My rap name was Big Pun.
Big Pun.
But somebody took it. Some other fat dude took it. It's all good, though.
Yeah.
I ain't mad at him. Yeah.
I never understood that when he wrote
Big Pun.
He had that song. It's like, what? If you weigh fucking 450 pounds, you shouldn't use the phrase "crush a lot."
Word.
He's like, no shit. Look at you. He's like,
hey man,
crush a lot. Yeah, every chick you try to fuck.
I was like, I don't crush a lot. I crush all the time.
Yes, every time.
Yeah.
Growing up in hip hop, so all the guys, we all had rap names and stuff, but as we're growing up, more rappers are coming out. So the one dude I went to school with, he called himself Eazy-E. He had to let that one go. You can't be
Somebody
Eazy-E
got famous
no more.
Yeah.
With your name, like, God damn it.
You can't even, like, try to claim that name now. Like,
no. Not like, even close. Like,
no,
so. Like, somebody come up and they're
you
like,
even just
hey, my name
said
is...
that, like, casually. Yeah. Somebody would go, what the fuck?
I can't even use the word easy. Yeah. Like, you were saying,
right. My friends call me Eazy-E. I just look at them like,
yeah, you're getting nerd bonus points.
Like,
yeah.
they're not your friends. Like,
yeah. They're obviously making fun of you.
Right, yeah. Exactly.
Because you're a dick.
How many ice cubes were there before?
Oh, I'm sure there's a lot.
Yeah.
Iced tea.
Yeah, all of them.
I always wanted Ice Cube and Ice Tea to put out a compilation record. You know? Because, I mean, what's better than Ice Cubes and Ice Tea?
Well, they call the album Arnold Palmer?
Yeah. That'd be fucking awesome. Dude, have
something
that,
like that.
What's that dude? Gucci Mane does that lemonade song?
Yeah, there you go.
Ice Tea, Gucci Mane, and Ice Cube. Arnold Palmer.
Gotta get Gucci now before he goes back to prison.
Yeah.
That's
his clone, man. That's his clone.
No, I mean, a guy like him, it's only a matter of time.
I knew
hey,
he
listen
was on house arrest.
Look at him judging the
I
guy.
I know, right?
Like, going down, dude.
Dude.
He's already got money on him.
It's just a matter
already,
of time.
If you've already made it, and you have money, and you do something stupid like that and get put in prison. Like,
what'd he do?
Pretty much stupid.
He had some gun charges last time. Is what he got busted for.
Yeah. What I'm just saying, it's just like when football players drive drunk. It's same as Gucci Mane. Like he doesn't have enough money that he couldn't have had all of his shit legal. Yeah. Like he probably could.
Or like spit on nurses or something like that.
He might. Well.
And a Pac-Man Jones.
Yeah.
He's just an asshole.
Hey, where was he? I just saw him in the news too.
Yeah, he got arrested for assault.
Oh man.
And then when the cops came, he headbutted a cop.
Did he?
Yeah, he fucked then, him up.
Oh, he headbutted a cop?
Yeah, that's what I said in the article I wrote. Damn. And I said the same thing. I was like, if that was me or you,
you'd be
maybe
shocked.
We were charged with assaulting an officer.
Yeah,
very
yeah but you're not. Your life ain't as valuable.
No,
as
that's what I'm saying. Pac-Man Jones. He's Pac-Man Jones. They only
he's the Bengals, man.
They only charged him with disorderly conduct.
Wow.
But then they charged him with assault when he went to the hospital and spit on a nurse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Then they said, fuck you.
Who the fuck spits on anybody anymore?
I
like, that's just...
That's what I said. It's like, what is this, 1978?
Damn, that proves so good. Yeah. It's like, spitting on somebody now is just...
Spit on the nurse.
You're
going to
put on some white gloves and then take it off and slap him in the face.
You think you really... You think you really spit on her like hock to it?
That's what they said. I mean, they charged him with the salt.
What I thought happened was, like, he was probably getting all, like... vulgar. Probably like, you know, when people get all pissed, he probably like, spit.
Was he like super drunk or something?
Yeah, I thought they said he was pretty intoxicated.
Well, then there you go.
Yeah. I'd have to be drunk to like want to spit on somebody. Yeah.
He had to be wasted.
Yeah, but I think
that's a thing in football. Romanowski did it to a couple people.
What, spit on people?
Yeah. Like,
my main thing is how is this going to affect the Bengals? All right, that's what this is really. Exactly. Hey,
the way I see it, it opened up a spot for a good player to fill. Ow. You know? Ow. Nah, Pac-Man Jones, he's actually he's pretty good. But let's face it, there's room for improvement on the Bengals.
I don't know.
You don't think there's room to improve?
Not really.
I mean,
I think they're about as good as it's going to get.
If they took like the all-star team and put them in the Bengals outfits, it'd probably
fired still the kicker
suck
out of everybody on the team. For real. Come on, man.
And the kicker always gets the fucking blame.
He does.
And he got like, the boot.
That's the first person. Yeah.
We'd be in the playoffs if it wasn't for you.
You ever notice that, though? Whenever a team's losing games, that's usually the first thing that happens.
That
like,
ain't right.
Like, man. Oh, they cut the kicker. It's like, and then bring in another kicker. It's like,
those three points really add up, bro.
No, but he really did cost them. Yeah. There's at least three games they should have won
due to a missed field goal.
They didn't win four if you count the one.
That's every year, though, for the past 30 years.
For the Bengals, yeah.
When they fired him, brought in the new guy, and then he missed.
He missed one. I know that's what I'm saying.
That was hilarious.
They should have hired me.
28-yard chip shot field goal for the win. Yeah. He's like, right to the sides. <He's> like,
I hope Nugent's at home fucking laughing like, goddamn motherfuckers.
It's like, dude, it's a curse. Some kind of weird curse.
When's the last time the Bengals actually did good? What was it, like 88, 89?
Yeah.
To the Super Bowl?
80.
Anything.
70?
They've been they went to the playoffs. The past.
When Boomer Esiason and Chris Collinsworth were on the team, they went. Well, Chris Collinsworth went to the Super Bowl twice. Once with Kenny Anderson. And then when Boomer Esiason took over, they went to another Super Bowl. And that team was, Boomer was quarterback. They made the playoffs pretty consistently. Sam Weiss was the coach. And they always made the playoffs, but they didn't go.
But it's been like 20 years at least.
Oh, yeah.
88-89.
Yeah, I think it was 88-89.
When Joe Montana threw on them in the last 24 seconds.
Both of those games.
We go like 90 yards in 22 seconds.
I'll never forget those games because both of those games were like, you know, you thought they were going to win.
He had two footballs. He just did like this and said, hike again through the.
Both of those games, the Bengals took the lead with like 2 minutes to go in the game or less. Both games. So, like, it's a Super Bowl. You just took the lead. There's like a minute 40 left on the clock, and you're like, we got this in the bag.
Man,
and
the Bengals.
Both times, fuck Joe Montana. Come out. fucking Jerry Rice. And fucking.
The Bengals, they got a lot of problems in them with turnover because they got like three new coaches, new assistant coaches all at once in three different positions.
Yeah.
In the middle of the year and stuff like that. It's like, you're going to make it real hard. Going to make it super hard on us.
Well, Marv's not a great coach. It starts from there. I mean, he's not terrible.
Now, hold on a second here. Hold on. Is it just me? Am I the only person that thinks this? I think a good playing team in any sport, whether it be football, baseball, whatever, I don't think the coach has a whole lot to do about it. I mean, if you've got some good, talented players.
It's the little man in that box upstairs calling down on the phone and telling the coach what to tell the assistants, to tell the players, to tell the other guys. That's the problem.
The coach is just the middleman. Yeah. I mean, I would just think, like, if you've got a team of good players, they're going to go out there and they're going to play fucking
good.
Do
they have the
– you know?
Now – the quarterbacks have a radio
on
their helmet?
The Bengals,
like just the quarterback though.
That I playoff think, yeah. game.
See, that's where the problem is.
That playoff
everybody
game.
Everybody needs one.
Everybody need a. This is me, Rogue 3. This is Rogue 3, Rogue 6 over here, Gold Leader. I got your Gold Leader. He's coming to the side. Watch out! Look over your back. Oh, he's coming! He's sitting behind me. I can't see him. Red Leader. It need to be like that. Yeah, man.
Then it'd be confusing as fuck.
That would be.
No, but listen, like, look at that game. Look at that game last year. They melted down, dude. in the end of that game because they don't have no discipline.
You described like every game from last season.
No, that's what I'm saying. They don't respect him.
No, they don't.
The players walk all over him.
Yeah.
And he has no control over the team.
I guess if I'm getting paid like millions of dollars to go out there and do what I do, and I don't like the guy I'm working for.
You'd be a dick too, right?
I shouldn't say working for. The guy who is over me that gets to tell me what to do. Yeah, I'd probably be a dick to him.
Yeah, but think about it. You're making millions of fucking dollars.
Yeah, but I can still make millions of dollars and still not listen to that cocksucker.
Yeah, but there's 51 other dudes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They
and they all feel the same way I do.
Not all of them.
No, well, I wouldn't say all of them.
Usually you have
how many of them want to just go home and play the game station?
Play
yeah.
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 And most of them dudes
are
pretty good,
I'm going to tell you
too.
Something, man. I know a lot of brothers, and if you gave them however much money, they going to come back and show up because they want some more checks.
Oh, yeah.
But I got the money now. I want to go drive my Porsche. I want to go holler at these honeys. So, we're not going to get to the Super Bowl this year. I'm telling you, man.
With all that money they're making, with all that money they're making, they can go to UDF and get all the 250 blowjobs.
They
get a lot. Yeah.
And you know how tired you be the next morning. You got to play football after all of them.
After you get your balls drained out.
So that you know,
they
out
there.
Clinic
afterwards.
Yeah, they out there getting their balls drained, and they're drinking and smoking and fighting each other and staying up.
Spitting on people.
Yeah.
But they got the check, man. So it, and in the program, everybody knows. Like you look at like the Dallas and the Steelers and them guys. Their programs are way bigger than ours. We are the best of the mediocre teams. We really are, man.
Yeah, you're,
the Bengals. Right, they are up there in as far as the mediocre farm.
Right below the fucking story franchises.
Yeah, so they get people kick them around too hard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I will say I think we're better than the Raiders.
Raiders had a good year.
No, Raiders
this year,
are better than us.
Oh, really?
Yeah, if their quarterback wouldn't have broke his leg,
that
he might have fucking done some.
Oh, man, how does that feel when
terrible,
you lose
dude.
Your...
Right at the end.
Yeah.
And then they put that fucking second quarterback in, and he got smashed,
Yeah.
Man. Well, that happened to our quarterback,
they were
too,
down in the room.
Several years ago.
Matt McGloin, like, who?
Who?
Yeah.
That dude from Penn State.
Is that meant to be like that? Is that fate, or is the other team cheating?
I just think the Bengals are doomed to not have a good season, period.
No, ever. what they do, Bengals.
That's not true. They've had good years.
They had a lot of good years.
The last 5 years, they made.
We
the
get
playoffs.
All the best players, but the way the system is designed is that all the best players come to the Bengals to get trained, the hardest training, to beat the hardest team, and then they go get the big contract and go on the Super Bowl team.
That's about the truth right there, yeah.
That's what Corey Dillon did at the end.
Yeah. Ocho Cinco almost pulled it off.
Yeah, he tried to.
Until he headbutted a chick.
But he was in the Super Bowl.
Dropping passes.
He was there.
Yeah. Prime example there.
What did he get from the Patriots? Yeah. That was Patriots?
Yeah. He sucked.
Yeah, dude,
he's like,
awful.
He didn't even look like himself.
Yeah.
Like, he used to be so good, and he was out there at the Patriots, so he just looked terrible.
Just fucked
like,
it up.
Who is this guy?
Maybe
is
he's
that
going
Chad
something.
Johnson?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he's going through all kinds of shit. He's crazy.
Hey, he's a prime example right there.
Yeah, that guy's nuts.
Of why you should stay away from the 250 blowjobs.
I hosted the Chad Johnson birthday party, Gary Owens and Chad Johnson, Newport on the left.
Yeah.
Nobody spoke to me.
Right.
Stood on stage for 45 minutes hosting the show. Place was packed.
Right.
Never even nobody shook my hand or nothing. Nobody said thank you.
That's fucked
Never
up.
Got paid.
Never got paid?
Never even got paid for the game?
Never got paid. Nobody said.
He's notorious for not paying.
Yeah, he is.
Hey, people after the show was like, man, you was hilarious, dude. Like, thank you. So I got paid that way. But
that's fucked up, man.
It is, man.
We talking Ocho Cinco or Trump?
Wasn't there some kind of contest at the Funny Bone that they did, and then...
They never paid anybody?
Yeah. Like, he was supposed to... somebody was supposed to win something, but he never came up with the prize. Or, there was some weird shit. I don't remember exactly what happened.
I remember every time I don't get paid.
Yeah.
He wouldn't remember.
He probably wouldn't.
Who are you?
Probably
just
wouldn't.
A host.
Yeah.
I'm just a person.
Actually, I don't think I've ever.
But it's not. It wasn't their responsibility to pay me anyway.
Yeah. I never met Ocho Cinco before, but I did see him at the Funny Bone once. And he's a lot smaller than I thought he would be. Like, he looks bigger on TV.
Everybody looks bigger on TV.
Yeah.
I'm 6'6 on TV.
I'm about 400 pounds.
Fucking huge.
Huge. Yeah.
I'm about 9 inches on TV. What?
Yeah.
Huge.
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 That I can tell you.
I think you're going to go hunt some dinosaurs, man. Rocking that Jurassic Park hat.
Mate.
That is a badass hat. Yeah. I do got to admit.
At least, that's what it looks like.
It was ice rain outside.
Ice rain.
I'm ready for the ice. I almost canceled on you guys because of the ice rain.
I wouldn't have blamed you at all, man.
Yeah, I wouldn't have blamed you.
Last word I heard tonight. It was all up north.
Supposed to have an ice rain at 7 o'clock.
That's how you know I'm getting old. Everything is about what time the weather's going to do.
Yeah. Like, man, it's going to start raining here soon. I better hurry up to the store and get back. I want to get my hair wet.
Ice rain coming.
It sounds so ominous. Ice rain.
Yeah.
It brings out all the 250 whores.
What drew her to me now that I think about it is that my white utility van that I was driving.
I can take you in the back of that van. Go to work.
Sir. Sir.
Excuse me, are you about a size 14? Give me the old Buffalo Bill.
There you go.
Maybe she just wanted a job, man.
She probably
not sucking.
She probably just wanted a nice dry place to catch a ride to.
Yeah.
You know? Like, she could get in the back of that van, spread her legs, air her crotch out or something.
Yeah, she was looking pretty specific. However you call it.
Was she putting, like, chapstick on? Putting the Abreva on?
Blistex.
No, yeah. She didn't. She didn't try to sicken me all the way in the beginning.
You at least wait until she got your pants down.
Like, yeah. When you were saying, I was like, man, how do you get to that point in your life?
Where you'd suck a dick for $250?
Yeah, where you're just like,
it'd take a lot more than
$250. Horrible shit, I don't even care anymore. I just need $250.
How do you catch that bus?
Like, is that what it costs to ride a bus? Is $2.50?
I think it's like $2. So we were trying to figure out what the fuck she needed the extra 50 cents for. Yeah. I said it was probably like breath mints or Tic Tacs.
Make a phone call. Doesn't a payphone cost 50
There's
cents?
There's no payphone
anymore.
Yeah,
I was saying,
that was 1997.
When I go to Chillicothe, outside of Steiner's Speakeasy, there's a fucking payphone.
But it's fake.
I mean, it's still. No,
it still works?
It's old. No, it doesn't work. Oh. But it's there. It's like, it's still there. And, like, it's got the fucking metal cord on it and shit. You know? It's just fucking hilarious. Like, standing there looking at it, like, it's like a time warp. Like, remember when that was a real thing?
Yeah,
phone. Like, there'd be a phone book hanging at the bottom of it.
Hey, yeah,
you can flip it up. Like, remember the Terminator? When he goes into the phone booth,
and
he flips it up the fucking, opens up the phone book, and he finds the Sarah Connors, and then he tears out the.
Back to the Future, another prime example.
Yeah.
That was like, what, the 55 or some shit.
He
flips it up, looks up Doc Brown, tears the page out.
Yeah.
You know how many times I wanted to look somebody up in the phone book and tear the page out? I just want to feel like a badass. Never did it, though.
I'm just saying, like, that's a weird thing.
I've gone to
people who are our age,
looking for it, and this page is torn out, like,
damn it! Yeah.
Somebody already fucking
beat me to it.
God damn it! No,
my page, the page I needed.
People who are our age, like I said, like, we're at this weird age where I remember everything. Like, when I was young, there was rotary phones.
Yeah.
There was no pagers.
I remember
there was
rotary
nothing.
Phones.
It was like pay phones and rotary phones.
You're really telling your age now, Bruce.
Yeah. Well,
the phone booth.
Whatever. It's just weird because there was no computers.
Yeah.
There was none of that shit. I mean, there were computers, but people didn't have them. Like,
they were probably about as big as
this
house.
It's a big giant thing as big as this fucking house that NASA had it or something.
Yeah.
And I remember when pagers came out, and then went from pagers to people started having phones, but they weren't like phones now. They're like
ginormous
fucking flip phone. Or my dad's friend had
every few years
car
from
phone.
Big to little to big to little.
Yeah, he had a car phone. It was gigantic. And he's like, call the car. Call the car and like pick it up. It's like
the car phone was like $2,500 a month.
Yeah, no, it's like $15.99 a minute.
That mug was high,
bro. It was
like
phone sex chat line fucking prizes.
Then you
I remember he had the phone in his car, and I was a kid, and I was like, can we call your phone? And he's like, yeah, you can call it. He's like, but we're not going to answer it. He's like, you can hear it ring.
Bad boy's like two-way ham radio.
Then, he's like, yeah.
Crank it.
He's like, if I pick it up, it's going to cost $10.
Hey, yeah.
I just want to say one piece of technology that you definitely should invest in, Bruce.
What's that?
Life Alert.
Definitely. Dude, it was exactly
tell us what happened on...
Well,
last Friday morning.
I woke up to go to work.
Jerking off in weird positions.
I just woke up to go to work. And I started walking to the bathroom. I got to the bathroom door, and it got back spasms so bad, dude. I mean, it hurt so
you
bad.
Had morning,
my knees
you
buckled.
Had morning wood that hard?
All the blood rushed to it.
My knees buckled, dude. I went down on the floor.
Wait, so you weren't even in the shower.
No. I'm like, now, I was laying on the bathroom floor for like 20 minutes.
I was picturing you like butt naked
in the shower.
No, listen.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
You're not letting me finish.
I'm just telling you what I'm picturing.
I was laying on the floor. Well, I'm about to get to that part.
Oh, okay.
What you saw is real.
Hurry up. Get to the part where you were naked laying on the floor for him.
He's like, are you naked yet?
Come on. I'm picturing you butt naked.
No, hurry up and get to that part. But I was laying on the floor.
Right.
And my back was seizing up so bad. I couldn't stand up.
Right.
So I was laid on the floor for like 20 minutes, occasionally like moaning, screaming. Then I felt, okay, I think I can get up. So I got up real slow. I got up. I'm like, I'll get in the shower and run hot water on it. That usually makes it feel
cleans
better.
Cleans the dick. I mean, cleans your back
at
off.
Least, at least it fucking...
relieves some tension.
Yes. Or loosen it up or whatever. So I turn on the shower, and I go in the shower, and I start to take a shower.
You can jerk off in the shower?
I'm standing there. What the fuck, man?
Go ahead, sorry. At least he's lotion or something?
He's getting to that part. He's getting to that part.
No. So I was like, the water's running on my back, and I'm like, okay. And I get shampoo, and I put shampoo in my hair. And I'm doing like this. And all of a sudden, I fucking did it again. And I'm like, ah, and I fell down. Now I'm in the bathtub. Felt like, dang, down on the ground. And I can't stretch my legs out. So my back is just seizing up.
It's like a Charlie horse?
And I'm like yelling, ah, you know. It's fucking fun.
Yeah.
It's 5:30 in the morning. God, I'm like screaming really loud.
Their neighbors are probably like, what the fuck?
That's what I said. I can't believe no one came or anything. So I'm laying.
We know you did.
You walk right into that one. I saw that coming a mile away.
So I'm laying there for like 30 minutes maybe. First water was running on me.
Dang, man.
Did you get like shampoo in your eyes and shit?
Yeah, it's all in my hair. So my head's just like slipping on the fucking tub. And I'm like laying there all curled up. And fucking water's running on me, so I used my foot to turn off the water.
I was going to say, how long did you let the water run for? Did it get cold?
Maybe it was ice cold, minutes. Probably.
No, it didn't get cold, but it started running in my ear and shit. So I turned it off in my foot, and I'm laying there. And that's what I said to myself. I'm like, this is Life Alert commercial. Like, this is a Life Alert commercial. Like, I'm stuck in the bathtub. I live alone.
Can't get up.
My phone's in the other room. Nobody knows where I'm at. I'm just laying in the fucking bathtub.
Just out of curiosity.
Pretty much crippled.
Describe for the viewers, the listeners.
Yes.
What type of faucet did your foot turn on? Was this separate hot and cold knob?
No. It wasn't knobs.
Was it the uni knob with the...
If it was knobs, I pretty much would have been fucked, I think.
He'd have drowned.
There's no way I could have turned
it off. Turn cold off first, like...
Yeah, burn myself, or either that, or turn hot off and be like yelling because it's fucking freezing. It was fucking awful. So anyway, I'm laying there.
You put it
like,
on cold, probably would help.
I'm like, what the fuck? I got to get out of here somehow. I can't just lay here all day.
Did you call your dog ever? Was your dog
like,
just
no, my
at
dog
you?
Kept coming in like.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And then like. Looking
what's
at
wrong
him.
With your rat?
Yeah.
Dog goes and rats. Runs out the door,
so
talks to the neighbors and shit.
So finally
Bruce is
like,
in the shower.
So finally, I'm like. Look,
Bruce is stuck in the tub?
I got, yeah, right.
Like, not the Timmy and Lassie. Yeah. What? Bruce turned the hot water off with his tongue?
He's getting shampoo in his eyes.
So anyway, I'm like, there's nothing to do except fucking Revenant this motherfucker. Have you seen The Revenant?
Yeah, like a bear.
I know what scene you're talking
about.
No, I'm
saying all he does is crawl and scream the whole fucking movie.
Okay, I got it.
I mean, it's a great movie, but I'm saying he's all like, ah, ah. And then he gets hurt again, and he's like, ah. So I was like, there ain't nothing to do but do that. And so I just grit my teeth and fucking get up. Like, that's all. I mean, that's all I can do.
Damn.
So I fucking.
So you didn't use lotion? I gotta keep asking, man.
He's so getting
I got
there.
Up, went into the other room, got my phone, called my work. It's like, I'm not gonna be able to. First, I text him.
You text your work?
I got my man, the store manager's numbers, so I texted him. I was like, yeah. Look, I got fucking back spasms. I just got up off the floor. I can't fucking come to work.
Can't guarantee I'm gonna
make it. You
know
you came.
But then I thought about. He's just going to keep running that play.
I am. I'm going
like,
to.
He's like the Bengals running a one-yard run up the middle over the and dump. Over and over. It's going to work sooner or later.
It's the, it's the dump off to the right, yeah. Tight end. Tight end dump off. It works 50%
like,
of the
then
time.
I was yeah. Like, I guess I should call this motherfucker. So I called him. And I'm like, I ain't going to make it to work. And while I'm talking to him, it fucking seized up, and I'm like, ah!
He's probably sitting on the other end of the line like, this guy's good.
No, I
he's
was
really playing
that,
it up.
Yeah. I didn't think I was bullshitting. It was like, it was awful.
I can see him like, I'm laying here naked on the floor. No, the guy's like, prove it. And he's like, fuck.
I'll FaceTime you.
Yeah.
Right. Snapchat. Yeah. You got Snapchat. Instagram. Do you have Instagram? I'll take a picture.
Dude, I'd have fucking died if I'd have
well,
turned
I'm scrolling through
Instagram. Yeah.
Bruce
Leonard
and
comedy. Holy shit.
It just says, someone please help.
Yeah. This is not a joke.
That was my only means
of
communication.
Got 1,000 yeah. Likes.
I've never been on Instagram.
Can you imagine like if social media was your only means of communication?
I don't want
to
imagine.
People
like
wouldn't know what to take serious and what not.
Yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. It would make it totally... The vibe would be totally different.
Bruce is
yeah.
Tweeting out, this is not a Trump joke. I can't get
right,
up.
Right, right. Someone come over here and piss on me, please.
Yeah.
It'll wake me up. Please. I've been bit by a jelly or stung
you know
by a
jellyfish.
Jellyfish.
You know, they keep saying it, that, you know, if it's true or it's not true, but it's like, come on, man. You can see.
Dude,
you can
what,
see him doing something like that.
That's how he's so fucking orange,
they
man.
They say he's yeah. germaphobe. Germaphobe.
Really? I heard that. That's what
I said. I don't think so. What you wouldn't pussy grab if you were a germaphobe.
Yeah.
How, like Howard Hughes didn't want no one to touch him. Like or Howard, yeah. Howie Mandel, like don't touch him.
Right.
Like, he's a germ. If he's a real germaphobe, he'd be like, don't fucking touch me. You know.
You're
if
left.
You touch him and jump back.
Like, Gene Simmons is like that. That Gene Simmons looking motherfucker's like that. Gene
yeah.
Simmons is.
He's a germaphobe.
Yeah, did
yeah.
you notice in the
is
movie?
Is he because he's notorious for fucking a bunch of chicks?
Why him? Did you notice he was fist bumping everybody? Fist bumping everybody?
Was he really?
Yeah.
I didn't pay
he's
attention
a
to that.
Yeah.
Huh. That's how Howie Mandel does too. He fist bumps.
Fist bumps, yep.
He don't shake
yeah, don't
hands.
Like to touch people.
He's a fist bumper.
What the
bumper.
Fuck? You're still fist bumping though. Like he could that dude
know,
be fist bumped. Could have fisted a chick.
That's
and
the thing about
like
it. It's so
night.
Fucking stupid.
Yeah. Yeah.
Every day I work in a grocery store, I watch people.
Like fish
they
shit?
Come in the grocery store, right? They get their cart. Then they get go to that thing. They get those fucking sanitizer wipes. They fucking wipe down the cart. And then they handle and everything. And fucking
and then they put their food
they,
in it and take it home
they,
and eat
well,
it.
No, then they fucking go in. And then first thing they do is go in produce or something. They start picking up fruits and vegetables. And you're like, you know that's grown in shit, right? I mean, pretty much that cabbage was, yeah, shit.
Yeah,
like,
but it was rinsed.
Then they go and they get the chicken or whatever. They're picking up packages of chicken and looking at them and shit. You're like, dude, there's germs all over all this shit.
Well, somebody touched
what's
it
the
to put it
point?
In there.
Yeah.
Then,
yeah.
Then at the end, they reach in their pocket and grab the filthiest substance on the planet, your money. That's, I mean, that money is fucking terribly. That's been scientifically proven.
They say like 90% of
that
money
was
a
fucking snorting a cocaine
shit.
Off
yeah.
a hooker's ass last night, or perhaps a suitcase and a gram of heroin in the urine-soaked pocket of a homeless man. And now you're. Thank God you wiped your cart yeah. off.
Thank God for those wipes.
Tune in next week, everybody. Thank you. Good night.
Dude, one time I worked in grocery store in Florida. And there was like a one of those homeless camps, like in the woods behind the store.
Yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. We get them around my work sometimes.
Yeah. Like where they would gather.
Yeah.
So what they would do is they would all go out. No, they were just bums. They all go out begging, and they'd come back.
They're gathering all the hubbalos.
They'd pool all their money, and they'd send one of them to fucking the cash and carry.
And buy
to
some
buy
booze?
The beer.
Right.
Yeah, they'd like buy like, you know, fucking a case, whatever they can afford.
The one
case
with the valid ID
or two
still, right?
Of, yeah. Of, you know, like Beast Ice or whatever the fucking Taste cheapest, ice. Nastiest, Taste most ice. Powerful beer they can get.
Right.
Cheap mouthwash.
So one day, this guy comes in, he's fucked up, dude. I mean, he's wasted.
Cobra. You ever had Cobra?
Cobra?
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Steel Reserve.
We got Cobra. We carry Cobra at my work, and I never heard of it. And they're like, have you ever seen Cobra? I'm like, no. They're like, holy shit. And I was like, damn, I thought Colt 45 was bad. Damn, Cobra's like,
if you're going to drink
shit.
Cobra, it need to be out, just getting out the deep freezer.
Yeah.
Instantly.
It's got to be crystallized. Somewhere. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If it even touches, like,
and you got
to
have your bail money ready. you better. It's Cobra.
Puke bucket.
You got to get that shit imported from Neptune.
Anyway, this guy's cold. Wasted, right? He fucking goes and he gets a case of Beast Ice. He comes up to the front. He puts it on the thing. And then you realize, oh, wow. You look at him. You're like, oh, wow. Like, he had pissed himself. Fucking all his pants.
Man.
We're all wet and shit, right? Oh. And he goes fucking.
Did he get the money?
Oh. And he goes, no, and it's changed.
Oh.
Starts pouring change out of his urine pocket, like right onto the conveyor belt of the fucking the thing, and the cashier standing there, like,
let me go get one of those wipes.
Yeah, exactly. You're gonna need more than a wipe.
Yeah.
Put your
clean up, check out, sir.
Yeah. No. What happened was, she calls the manager, and he comes up, and then he looks at it. And he look at them, and he's like, just go.
That's what I would have said. Just go.
And then they put on gloves and, like, clean, like a biohazard cleanup.
I would have coin-starred that shit.
Yeah.
Like, fuck this. Coin-star it, man.
That's just
rough. I'll never forget that, though. Like, you see some crazy shit working in a grocery store sometimes. But
I believe it.
That was
you
one
see
of
some
the,
crazy shit just shopping at a grocery store.
That was one
store.
Of the crazier things. It's like...
That is pretty fucked up.
He must have had fucking 5 pounds of change in his pocket. I mean, it just coming out. And his pants, I said, were all soaked and shit. It's like, you're like, all this money's got piss all over it. And fucking, like, and she just looking at it like, no one's going to pick that up.
That's
she,
just gross.
She just picked up the phone, called the manager, like, immediately. And then he came, and he's like, man, they're all, like, eyeing it. Like,
damn, man. I hate to be the one to bitch, but I'm fucking sweating. Fucking heater, hey, working, dude.
Motherfucker, bitches, that we got no heat down here. So I buy a heater. What's he do? Starts stripping.
Remember, sweating, son.
Damn, Tyrone, you ever run any kind of crazy shit like that? Doing anything? You ever worked in a convenience store or
anybody
grocery
offer
store?
You a blowjob for $2.50?
No, my first job was at Kroger's.
Oh yeah,
yeah, 16.
What'd you do? Wrangle the carts?
I was the bagger.
Cart wrangler.
Mm-hmm. You ever find crazy shit in a cart, somebody left over, dirty diaper or something?
Dude.
You know what?
I see that shit all the
time.
That.
Yeah.
The Kroger's in Kenwood was so upscale back in the 80s that all the rich people come up there, so I got to put the groceries in the Pete Rose wife's Rolls Royce.
What? Oh, really? That's the shit right there.
Did you fuck her?
She didn't have $2.50. She didn't have her.
You put the groceries in, and you just turn like, ma'am, for $2.50.
ma'am.
I will give you full service.
I'll go to work. But nothing crazy like that, though. No urine. Soak, change, nothing like that?
You know, that type of stuff I block out of my mind. I see it every day. It ain't even, it's nothing to me now.
Don't even faze you.
You're like
yeah,
this
I
one.
See it,
One time I was working in a bar in Florida.
Right.
It's called Gasoline Alley. And I was the bar back. And, but it was really two bars, like, joined together.
Yeah.
And
right.
It was kind of like three, because they had like a live music club on this side. You go in here and they had like a fajita hut little bar there, And then if you turn right and went into the back, like a game room.
Right, okay.
So there's a bathroom all the way in the back. It's like a one long straight shot, and front door is on this side, and then bathroom in the back.
Straight
so
back.
So they come to me, and they go, there's an emergency in the back bathroom.
Oh, shit.
I'm like, what? I'm like, there's an emergency in the back bathroom. I'm like, okay. So I walk back there. I open up the fucking door, and it's just a pair of pants on the floor.
Just a pair of pants.
I'm like, what the fuck? No. And then I, took a step in. It's like, shit, in the pants. Someone shit their pants at the bar. Then they went into the bathroom, took the pants off.
And just walked out?
No, that's what I said. Yeah. My first thought was, how'd this motherfucker get
walked
out
with no pants?
Was it pants and underwear?
Like, how did this happen? Who did it? Yeah, it was everything. Full drawers.
Damn.
It's like there was a load of shit in the pants.
How the fuck did they get out without nobody seeing them?
I mean, he had a long shirt on. Come on.
That's what I said, though. Was like,
he pulled his socks way up.
Yeah. Like, what in the fuck? How does this happen? One, how's it happen that you just release your full load right into your fucking pants? I mean, it wasn't like a shart. It was like a dump. like
full-on lumpy.
Yeah, curve. Yeah, like there was no salvaging it. And he knew it. That's why he just left in pants. Like, there's no way out of this.
It may have started out as a shart, and he was just like, fuck it. I'm going to get another beer, and I'm just going to let this one ride for a few minutes.
I don't know, man.
It was the middle of the afternoon, too. So like,
I would just like to know how somebody could get out of the bathroom without nobody noticing.
That's what I said. Like, how did he get out of here?
How did it get?
That's a mystery that would never
how did
be
it
solved.
Get to Bruce? There's an emergency in the back bathroom. Why wasn't it like Bruce? There's some naked dude running through the fucking store.
Exactly.
Get him. That's
crazy.
That almost sounds planted. Yeah. You know, like somebody brought an extra pair of pants
just to fuck with you.
Yeah.
It's like Impractical Jokers.
Something. Mm-hmm. That's fucking crazy.
I remember when my first job was fucking Chucke Cheese.
Chucke Cheese?
Yeah.
Hand jobs in the fucking costume closet.
Yeah, I ain't going there. But anyways.
He done told me about
some
it.
Kid,
I know.
Some kid shit on the slide and a bunch of other kids decide they're going to slide down the shit and fucking smear it all the way down. Yeah. I had to work game room, so if you work game room, you had to clean the tubes. Dude.
That's some hepatitis just waiting to happen.
Yeah, all them fucking...
No so 250
like,
needed for that.
All those nasty little kids.
Yeah.
Fucking.
They all had shit on them. Like, all from their ass to their the back of their head. Had shit all over them, dude.
And their parents
so
are probably
bad.
Like, how come you guys don't clean your slides?
Right, this is your fault.
Yeah. Yeah. It's bad. I had to go up there with a mop and mop it out. Dude, it sucked. I used to be a dick. I used to take Pledge. You had you're like Pledge. You ever put Pledge on plastic and wiped it really good? Shit's like fucking butter.
It's super slick.
It's
yeah.
super slick. So I used to fucking put Pledge on the slide. And just fucking slide down that shit. Yeah.
Another one flew out the ball pit.
Yeah. I like to also have these kids run around. They had these big cup full of tokens and they'd be running. And everybody be yelling, stop running. I won't fucking yell at them. I just let them run. And I fucking love it and they tripped and the fucking tokens flew everywhere. It was hilarious. That was one of my favorite things.
I could see that being very gratifying.
It is, dude. It is. And they would just fall and their fucking tokens fly everywhere.
Little bastard
so
kid.
It's my favorite. It was my favorite.
Kids have no regards for tokens either.
No.
They just
fucking. Daddy, give me $20.
Yeah.
I need some more tokens.
That $20 of tokens is gone in 3 minutes.
Yeah.
And they ain't coming
literally
back
is.
I need some more tokens. Yeah. Like, dude,
you
that's it. I told you that was it, then.
You need to get a job.
They're all fiending for y'all
got you got some
tokens?
Parents that get their child three tokens? We're going to be here for 2 hours. You better play it, get an extra man, or get all the tickets on the first token.
Yeah. That's the thing, man. The fucking best games took the most tokens. Mm-hmm. And
it's a racket.
Yeah.
And the least games gave the less tickets.
They don't even have tokens anymore. They give you a swipe card.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was teaching us how to be addicted to gambling is what it was.
Yeah.
It's conditioning.
Yeah.
Showbiz Pizza Place, that's what we had.
Showbiz, yeah. And then Chucky Cheese bought them out.
Yeah. Chucky Cheese is after that.
Yep.
So tell us about the hand jobs in the costume closet, Dust.
I never got a hand job in the costume closet.
Come on, now.
I got people in the
He's getting
this.
All coy now.
It's bitch, somebody I know is watching this.
We off the show. He'd be like, "She sucked my dick."
I was dressed up as Chucky and she blew me hard, yeah, man.
I heard that story. That's true. Like, I haven't
dressed up like the Elvis lion.
Yeah. I was all acting all animatronic, and she was just back there just blowing me.
Where's Rob Wilfong right now? He's with the band. Yeah.
Man.
Oh, shit. So, Tyrone, like I said at the top of the show, you've toured, like, nationwide, right?
Yeah, I'm going to Kennewick, Washington to do Jokers next weekend.
Oh, shit. Nice.
Yeah, three nights.
I've never been to Washington, but I hear it's nice. They got medical up there.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it's like, isn't it full on legal?
Yeah, it's recreational now.
Yeah, so that's pretty cool. I always wanted to get like a job in Washington, like growing weed or something.
Snowing out there now.
Picking apples.
growing weed, man.
Washington apples. Yeah, that's a beautiful, picturesque place to be.
Have you been there before?
Been there since 1998.
Damn.
Washington, that is. You talking about to the comedy club or to Washington?
I'm just talking about Washington in general.
Yeah, I lived out there.
Oh, that's cool. Did you? You actually lived. That's cool.
I still stay out there from time to time.
Oh, hell yeah.
Mm-hmm. That's been my Washington, Cali, and Ohio. That's my 3-point, you know.
It's your triangle.
So just, yeah, that's my triangle. So I work that circuit through there. Each area grows whatever it grows.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
What part of California do you stay in?
Down in Hollywood, man.
Hollyweed?
Hollyweird.
Yeah, Hollyweird. Yeah.
Go down there. Network, come on back. Network, come on back.
Hell yeah.
Come on back. Network, leave. Go up there. Go back down there. And then after I go down there, I go back up there and come on back.
So you go pussy titties, pussy titties. Pussy tap, just kidding.
Pussy
if that
tap.
Helps you to remember the, if that helps you to remember my job.
This guy's sexually oppressed, man.
He's like, no, I'm not.
He's very, very sexually frustrated.
He's like, everything is like turned into a
sexual
reference of some sort.
Like, hey, pussy titties, pussy titties. I did not get a hand job in the fucking closing Chucke Cheese. I don't know what you're talking about. Pussy titties, pussy titties. No hand jobs. Pussy titties.
Yeah, the mind tries to process. It's like you're talking about, yeah, so I go up to him. Oh, so pussy titties, pussy titties. Okay.
Yeah,
all right.
Sure.
That's your combo.
It's like
you're sweating over there, man.
I'm burning up.
You're sweating like a whore in church.
I am.
Pussy titties. Pussy titties.
Sweating like I'm getting a hand job in a Chucke Cheese closet.
Yeah.
Sounds like there's a regular circus going on there.
Well,
like kids running around and shit, and they're in there whoring in the closet.
There's some shit that went on there. I wasn't part of it, but I just heard shit.
He heard some shit.
Yeah, heard some
first
shit.
Hand.
Chucke Cheese, they never had any scandal, had they?
Not yet.
Not yet. Not till tonight.
Yeah, not till
tonight.
We're
going to write a scathing expose.
Yeah. I'm just thinking, like, how many times have we taken the kids to Chucke Cheese here?
Right.
I heard of once, I don't think it was Chucke Cheese, though, but the ball pit is very dangerous.
It is, man. They took all of them out.
Yeah, the ball pit.
They don't even have ball pits anymore?
No, man. Donald Trump showed up, and they fucking ruined it for everybody.
What's he got to do with the ball pit?
They piss in it, man. Pee all over that shit.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine a ball pit being nasty like that.
I don't know why.
It's just like the swimming pool.
Yeah, they think they're swimming or something.
You ever got the fucking, like, the public swimming pool, and they're like, oh, there's that baby pool over there.
Yeah.
And they're like... If you just touch it,
just
like,
full of piss.
It feels like fucking
hot tub.
It feels like a hot tub. Yeah, yeah. Like you put your fucking.
It's not
like,
a.
Bradley
touch
the wire, like, holy shit!
This water's 98.6 degrees.
Yeah, like it's human body temperature.
It has a slight yellow tinge to it.
Yeah.
I like when it's the mamas put the babies in their Pampers in the
pool.
Baby. Oh, yeah, like, are you that's what you're gonna do?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Full on book bag between his legs.
It's like a fucking toilet.
Yeah.
It's like you might as well just put your kid in a toilet. Like,
yeah.
People do it. They get in there with them.
I never forget the time when I was at Kings Island. I was fairly young. I'd say it was about like middle school. Me and my cousin were walking around at the water park.
So last week.
Yeah, last week.
Rub it into the old guy. I was fairly young.
While we're looking at titties and pussy, pussy and titties.
Last time I seen pussy and titties, I paid $2.50 for it.
Anyway, so
I paid for that shit in tokens, man.
So what happened?
Anyways, we're walking. Me and my cousin were walking. There was this girl. I guess she was like with her mom. You know, I can't remember. This girl was like, man. She was like, oh, mom, I gotta pee. She's like, well, bathrooms are up here. Dude, she got like 5 foot. She squatted and pissed right in the middle of fucking Kings Island on concrete, dude. Dude, I'll never forget that. Like, and like, yeah. She squatted like she was on a toilet. So I was like, what the fuck? That chick just pissed in the middle of Kings Island in front of everybody. What,
dude, one night.
Had she been in the pool? Was she dripping wet?
No, she was bone dry, dude. Like, damn. Like, she just got like out of the car, like walked to the park. Like, I gotta piss. Awesome, dude, she just straight squat down and just pee.
Did she piss through her? Did she have a bathing suit on?
Yeah.
She pissed through it or she pulled off to the
no,
side
she
of
pissed
it?
Through it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, straight up, dude. It was, I'll never forget it.
She's like, gangster.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dude, I was in the drive-thru at the Taco Bell in Taft. This is like a couple years ago. I worked at the Mad Frog. I stopped to get some food on the way.
Tyrone sounds like Cleveland. Someone said that.
Cleveland Brown?
Cleveland shop. Three white guys and me and a bear.
But no, oh, man. I'm in the drive-thru, and in the line, and yeah, the car in front of me, door just opens, fucking big black chick gets out, just fucking grabs the car and the door just like this, and just fucking rumbles down.
Yeah, man,
just
we got
just let it go right there, like headlights on her and everything.
Wow. That shit like a whitewater rafting trip.
She can't give a fuck.
Man, let's like, talk about something shit. Else, man.
Tyrone's about to get sick over here.
Been an hour pissing shit.
Welcome to the Tell You How Brown Boys, man.
I gotta go. I got a hot date.
Tell us about your date, man.
Yeah,
I don't know nothing about her, man.
Is it a Tinder
is
date?
Is it 250?
No, me and 250 ain't gonna do nothing.
He's waiting for the price to drop.
Half price at midnight.
Yeah, I know. If I just hold out till about 1 o'clock, she'll do it for a dollar. Yeah.
I got that change in my console.
Yeah.
I keep 250 on me now.
So, is it like a Tinder date? Is that what's going on here? I've never used Tinder.
I heard about that, but I never done that before. What happened was, Facebook, some chick, Facebook friend, she's ready to meet.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
What if she, like, hit you up here in, like, 10 minutes, like, yeah, you got 250?
I'm watching you.
Like, make sure you like, stop by the bank, get that 250.
You know, I'm trying to just get out the house. It's Friday.
There you go.
Oh, yeah?
I'd like to take this time now to thank you white people for inviting me out for the Martin Luther King weekend podcast special.
Yeah, that's exactly what we're doing.
Yeah,
tonight.
I know, man. And I take you taking strides like this really helps us all understand each other, man.
We're just doing what we can, man. Yeah. You know,
come on,
I get to go back to my
for a long time.
Yeah, we have, man. You know, so I appreciate any time y'all go out your way.
We had Glenn Childress on the show last week, and I asked him if he was going to invite me to his barbecue. He said no. I was kind of pissed. I was like, damn it, Glenn. Come on.
Glenn is a little racist to me. I met Glenn. I don't know.
he brings out the racist in me.
Yeah. Does he?
Well. He does. Like, I can't help it. Like, I don't consider myself a racist person. Like, I love all races, all shapes, all colors, all sizes.
Something about Glenn.
Something about Glenn just makes me want to be like... Them damn niggers. Damn them.
Yeah, they going back through the 1700s.
There's something about him. I don't know what it is.
I don't know, man.
I don't know.
Glenn, you got to watch him. You got to watch
him. He's a wily one, man. I don't know.
Yeah, what y'all doing for Martin Luther King Day?
We're having a barbecue. We're gonna grill out. We're going to have some... Ribs,
yeah, I like ribs.
Really, that's about it. Just some ribs. I could go real bad, but I'm just going to stick with ribs. You got me thinking about Glenn now.
You ain't going to have no black-eyed peas?
No. No black-eyed peas.
Collard greens.
No collard greens. No chitlins.
You don't have no chitlins?
Chitlins.
I was down in North Carolina. Damn. Yeah, chitlins. My grandma fixed some chitlins.
What is it?
Pig intestine.
Is that what it is? I didn't know that. Yeah. Okay.
That's disgusting, man.
It's just a pig, man. It's all the same.
It is, but if
just I as long as you, if you're going to eat a pig intestines, it would behoove you to clean
all of
it.
Yeah,
that's
what I'm saying. You got to make sure you clean that shit out. Like,
literally clean the shit.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
It's shit in them. Like, you got to clean it out.
Yeah.
And like, I'm like, nah. It's like kidneys. We used to get kidneys.
What?
I can never eat
in the meat department. Mm-hmm. We you get everything.
Kidneys had the same texture as the liver.
Yeah, they feel the same, but you can smell the piss, man. When you're wrapping them up, and then like when you get them, you have
to
soak them.
Why wouldn't you just throw them out? Like, who the fuck eats that shit?
Because people over time.
It's freaking slave food, man. So if you throw out all the guts
in England and Ireland,
they'll figure out how to cook that.
Like when countries where they don't have a lot of shit,
they
eat every single thing. They don't waste nothing. So
I mean, I can understand that if you're like an Indian.
No, but I'm saying
Native
like
American
you can smell the piss in the kidney, like it's a big kidney, and then when you're wrapping it in packages, you can smell the piss. When you buy them, you got to take them home and put them in salt water, and it draws out the urine from the inside the kidney before you can cook it. You can't just if you just bought the kidney and you didn't know, you were stupid. It's like, oh, I have to go try that. You go home and cook it. It'd be fucked up because it's still got.
It's Donald Trump's dinner right there.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a Trump steak.
Tasty. Yeah.
That's a Trump steak.
unsoaked
Trump nuggets.
Trump
nuggets.
I don't know if Trump likes these unsoaked kidneys.
I'll tear up some fucking chicken livers though, man. They're so bad for you.
You like chicken livers?
I like the gizzard. I like livers, man. The livers.
Yeah.
I don't really. I like a chicken.
Yeah,
plain
meat.
Little chicken.
That's how I like the dark meat myself.
Any freaking baked, broiled, fried,
nuggeted.
It's really not a bad way to make chicken. No. I mean, it's pretty much good no matter how you do it.
That roasted chicken from Bob Evans is good shit. You guys ever had that?
Yeah, Yardbird, man. I eat all that Yardbird up.
I don't think I've ever had broiled chicken.
They're called broasted.
Or broasted.
It's good
broasted.
Yeah.
What about dog? Anybody had dog?
I've had Chinese food, so I'm pretty sure I've eaten dog before. Dog,
no, that's cat.
Cat.
Thai.
Thai food is dog?
No, I don't know. I'm just saying.
I'd eat a fucking dog. I'd eat my fucking dog.
Can you eat dog?
You eat Rico?
Yeah. I'd eat the shit out of it.
Can you eat cat?
Yeah, you can eat cat.
Probably.
Why don't people eat dog and cat?
I don't know. I've tried horse before.
Yeah.
I had horse meat
I've
before.
I've had horse, ostrich, bison.
You know where I had horse meat?
Where is that?
Banger Naval Base in Bremerton, Washington.
Really?
That's in Washington.
The Navy.
Were you in the Navy?
No.
No.
Construction. Johnson Controls.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Horse What's the weirdest meat? Thing you ever ate? Like, I had squirrel. You ever had squirrel?
Yeah, squirrels.
I made deer chili today. That's pretty common.
Yeah, deer
though.
Is pretty common.
But if you can eat deer, you can eat cat and dog.
Start getting down to like, you know, people that
There should be no shortage of food anywhere in this country, man, because I almost hit 6 deer today.
Yeah, but if you actually nail a deer, it kind of kills the meat.
Yeah.
You know,
it brings all the blood up and it bruises it.
Yeah.
Not good for you to eat it.
Mm.
Which is like if you hit a dog. Like, if I'm going to eat a dog, I don't want to run over it first. I want to just, like,
break its
neck or something.
You know? You kill it humanely just like any other pig or cow. You put the prod in the head of the brain.
That No Country for Old Men thing.
Yeah.
humanely.
Yeah.
Hey, you know, I actually know a guy who, I don't think he does it anymore, but he used to work for a slaughterhouse. And what it was a bolt gun.
Yeah.
Now, when you hear bolt gun, you think like, yeah, Fallout 3, the bolt gun. No, it's literally like he had like a 3/8 fucking bolt, and he would put it in the chamber and fucking, and it would fucking shoot the bolt. And then he'd fucking dig the bolt out and fucking reuse it.
Dig it out.
Dig it out.
Yeah.
That seems labor intensive.
He said it wouldn't like go straight in, like it would go in deep enough where it would fucking kill the animal. And then he just fucking just pull it out. Yeah.
Just pull it out. I had alligator. Bone crunching sound.
Alligator's actually good.
Every single time I have ever ordered alligator at a restaurant,
you get the shits.
They're like, I'm sorry, sir, we're out. And it's like, motherfucker, this is
You know what else
time.
Is good? Frog legs.
I like frog legs. I've had frog legs. It's not something I go for, but I've eaten them, and they taste just like a chicken wing to me.
I had them at Papa Do's.
Yeah.
Papa Do's
good. It's out in Springdale.
But see, you got to cook it. I want you to cook it hard for me. Cook it all the way.
Crunchy.
Yeah.
He's like, I don't want no medium rare frog.
I don't want Kermit ribbing it at me.
Yeah.
You see that picture that's on Facebook?
Which one?
And the chick was like, I made some medium rare chicken strips.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I can't wait to fucking try this in my salad or something. Yeah. It's like raw chicken. Yeah. This is braised on either side. Yeah.
Get the shits in salmonella.
I saw that. Yes, I was just like, will. Damn.
Yeah, you're about to die. Will,
yeah. That's just nasty.
People are so fucking dumb.
Stupid.
I think that was fake, though. Like, I don't think.
I know.
Somebody really meant to do that, but I can picture somebody out there.
There's someone that's stupid.
There's a guy at Olive Garden just got caught, just that was doing that.
What, really?
Yeah, my buddy worked there, and he was telling me just a couple weeks ago, this dude's got in trouble 3 times for not cooking the chicken all the way.
Damn.
And he's like, dude, this Olive Garden, you ain't got but 2 ways to cook the chicken.
That's so true.
Yeah.
Fucking well done and extra well done. Blackened.
Yeah. Like, man, he's trying to do that on purpose.
You're trying to make motherfucker sick.
Mm-hmm. Now, whenever I cook chicken, I cut the motherfucker in half and look. Say, thank you. It ain't fucking peace.
That's right.
Yeah. Like, you got to make sure it's
cooked. This ain't a TV show. Cut that mug up and see the inside.
Yeah. I don't want to have to guess. I want to know for sure.
I had a girlfriend one time cook for me. And she put salt on the pork. Like, pork was already... The corn was hard. Everything was wrong. And then she brought me the plate one, watch me eat it. I'm like, man, I can't eat this.
He's like, but I really want to fuck you.
I ain't got $2.50, like, so I better eat up.
Trying real hard to get it down. Like, I want to fuck you, but this food is so awful.
And yeah, that's Bruce saying that, not me. I was about to ask, like, was her titties hanging out?
Like, when you're dating somebody or something like that, and she's fucking...
She wants to cook for you.
And then, like, you start eating and it's fucking terrible. You're like... No, it's good.
Hey, man, I'm older now. I don't hold back. I'm not eating that. I'm sorry, baby.
But the dog told me that it really wanted to eat this.
He's like, you little liberal with that salt.
I can cook, so I don't even play around. Right. It's like, hold on, baby. Hold, I see what you're trying to do, but let's...
Bitch, I got to watch my sodium.
I can't eat that. I'm a 45-year-old black man. You trying to kill me. Blood pressure.
Are you 45?
Yeah, man.
I never would have guessed that.
I never would have guessed that.
After I ate that salt pork steak she fixed you. Yeah.
Were they Trump steaks?
Trump
steaks.
They were salty from the urine.
Yeah.
Hey, what you got? Kidneys in there?
Liver and onion. People always come down to it.
No, I don't eat no liver and onion.
Me neither, but some people love it.
Yeah. I'm to the point now where...
I don't like liver, but I don't like because it's like... It gets like chalky in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it's
like
weird consistency. And like,
I don't like okra for the consistency either.
Like, the flavor of it's not so bad.
Unless it's in
but
gumbo.
But like the way it gets like pasty in your mouth, I don't like that shit.
The only time I eat livers is chicken livers. They gotta be fried and they gotta be fresh. Like,
from Popeyes.
Popeyes or Lee's.
Yeah, like that.
They gotta be covered in salt and pepper and they gotta be fresh. Like, they can't be sitting around like all green, like KFC style. Fuck that shit, dude.
KFC
doesn't have real meat anymore.
No.
They had to change their name from Kentucky Fried Chicken to KFC because the K stands for clone fried chicken. That's what it is.
It's not real meat.
It's not.
I always used to imagine, like...
I got to go to the bathroom 2 minutes after I eat it.
Some, like, farm where there's, like, Franken chicken. Yeah. They're like, so fucking big that they can't do anything. There's laying
the one
on
chicken got six
got, like,
wings, three wings on one side, three on the other.
They got fucking, like, four breasts, and they're, like, laying on the ground all deformed. And
then the bobcat come and push them down.
Yeah, it's like, they gotta do something.
I seen it, man.
Have you guys seen the video where what they do with shit. Like the male chickens or whatever, or the something that's like in a factory?
The roosters.
Yeah, well, it's like it's like baby chickens. Mm-hmm. But it's like they take.
Oh, then they push them into that big grinder.
Yeah, they just like live, yeah. Just dump them right in.
Furring
off.
Yeah. It's like a big giant food processor.
It's like,
yeah. And they just push them in. Yeah, it's like beep, beep, beep.
It's got a thing in where the yellow feathers just blessing out of it.
It's pretty awful.
That's terrible.
Yeah, I forget what, like, why I watched that video, but I watched it, and I was just like, damn, that sucks.
I saw one where they got caught with the, you know, the mad cow.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So they're taking, now the USDA has passed that these cows can still go down the line. But what they do now is that they shoot them with 3 chemotherapies and then put the stamp on them.
What? Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what like causes
that's bullshit, man.
It's the purple light. They're hitting the purple light like gang. Go down to the next one, gang. Go down to the next and gang. Put the stamp on them. So they caught the lady with the forklift picking the cow up, like just rolling him down in the thing, man. He getting it too. Damn. He couldn't walk or nothing. He was just shaking.
He was all fucked up.
Yeah. I said, man, I'm about to stop eating this stuff.
No shit, dude.
For real, man.
That's fucked up.
You know what causes mad cow, right? You know, like what started it.
Hip hop.
Like, yeah.
Damn niggers again.
That's why we got the mad frog.
It was either that or the Jew.
Yeah. Shit.
Feeding cows, other cows' brain matter, man.
They were.
And the E. coli comes from the daggone cows don't eat corn. Cow don't just eat corn like that.
Right.
So they just overfeeding the cow the corn, and then so what naturally happens is the enzymes turn in E. coli in the freaking stomach lining.
I didn't know that's how you got E. coli. I thought E. coli came from chickens.
No, yeah. E. coli salmonella. Comes from shit.
Salmonella comes
really?
From chicken.
Salmonella. Yeah. Salmonella is chicken. Salmonella is that dude that works at that bar down in Covington.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's a cool cat. He hooks me up on drinks.
Yeah.
Shout out,
that's
salmonella.
What he call himself?
No, I'm just making a joke.
Oh, okay.
That's what he calls himself.
That's a hard name right there.
Rudy's Bobby, alias Salmonella.
Salmonella. Hang out with him long enough, he gives you the shits.
He'll
I thought
fuck
his
you up.
First name was Simon. So they just called him Salmonella.
That'd be awesome. Fucking.
That's a hard name.
Salmonella.
Yeah.
Salmonella.
Yeah. What's your nickname? Fucking Ebola.
Yeah.
E. coli.
Ebola, that's some shit. Ebola, yeah. Dude.
That's you something you don't hear about no more.
That's what I'm thinking about, E. coli. That's what the cows
do. They bleed out their eyes and shit. Yeah. You get a cold or Ebola.
Like basically, blood hemorrhage, man.
What Ebola, what is Ebola from?
Africa.
Well, everything's damn from dangerous. Africa. All of it's from Africa.
God damn it.
Africa, the first everything is from Africa.
Everything comes from Africa.
Well, yeah, the mosquitoes.
Everybody came from Africa.
Killer bees. So, you know?
That's why I think that. That's why I was saying. That's why I always laugh at the fucking stupid white supremacists. Like, you're fucking dumb. Like, we all came from the same place. Even though we all branched out and became different.
Ain't no bees. White man in his mind want to hear that he come from Africa.
He don't want to hear it, but it's fucking true.
White people come from America. Everybody knows that. Then the Indians came along and tried to steal their land.
They took our land!
Indians. Oh, shit.
Yeah, I was just about to say, oh, shit.
Yeah, man. Happy Martin Luther King weekend.
Yeah.
I got to work Monday. I'm pissed.
I tried to call off, too.
I was telling him I kind of wanted to go down to that march. They're doing a march.
Are they doing a march in Cincinnati?
They're just walking from the Freedom Center to Fountain Square. But then there's going to be like a speaker.
Ain't a very far march.
They're going to have ribs or anything? Man.
That's a walk.
Yeah.
Let's go for a walk.
He's not going to have ribs or anything.
Jesus Christ.
I mean, I might leave work early and come down.
The legacy of a great man.
He's a true American, man. Every holiday is about food, right?
Exactly.
St. Patrick's Day. Or what do you St. celebrate?
St. Patrick's Day is about booze.
Yeah.
So well, that's about drinking.
I ain't even Irish.
St. Patrick's Day is about drinking.
You're not Irish?
I'm not Irish, but I celebrate it.
Everyone does.
What's your lineage?
I'm a mutt. I have no idea what the hell I am.
What do you know?
No, I'm like, I know I'm mostly German.
What about you?
That name.
I'm not fucking no white supremacist, Bruce. Goddamn. No.
I
wonder how many people
know,
really.
Got that Nazi blood running through them.
I think I'm like Polish and probably some German and Polish and I don't know.
I'm 99% black, 1% African American.
I wouldn't have guessed. I'm glad you told me that.
You know what that means?
What's that mean?
I mean, I got 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one.
Hit me. Oh, man. Well, hey, folks, I think that's going to be our time this week. I think we've definitely hit our limit. Thanks, everybody on Facebook, for watching.
I can say, you said no limit. Oh, no, you said our limit.
Shout out to MC Salmonella.
Yeah. And E. coli.
And E. coli.
Literally making them say,
But, yeah, for real, though, shout out to our sponsor, Club Vape. Hit the fucking button. Bam! Club Vape. Three locations in Northern Kentucky, Heber and Taylor Mill, and on Mall Road in Florence, Kentucky. Check them out. They got a cloud comp coming up on February 11th. Go check it out. Sponsored by Hard Hitter Vapes and Scarab Box Mods. Go check them out. Show them some love. Anything else I can fucking say? Follow us on Twitter, Instagram, Periscope, fucking Snapchat. All that shit.
No dick pics, please.
The Bulletproof Armadillo on YouTube. Y'all check me out, man.
Is that what you're on?
Yeah.
The Bulletproof Armadillo. Okay. And where else can we find you on social media?
Rooftoppro.com.
Okay.
For all your listeners, y'all get a free 45 minutes if you go to Tyrone Hawkins on rooftoppro.com. You can see your whole set.
Hell yeah.
For free.
Good deal. Well, Tyrone, definitely thanks for coming in. We appreciate you, man.
Thank you, man.
We'll have to get together again in the future. Hit me up on Monday, man. We're having that barbecue. We're going to have some ribs and some pig's feet. Probably some grape Kool-Aid.
You ever ate pig feet?
I've nibbled on them a little bit.
Man, we grew up on that, man. We ate the hog from that Uncle Oscar killed in the yard and cooked him all the way up.
Was he like a pet?
I've been to a pig roast.
No, you don't name him. You don't name him.
You don't name him.
That's against the law, man.
Yeah, you don't name him.
You don't grow in love and then go snack on your friends. You don't do it.
Hey, yeah. I'd eat my dog if I had to.
See, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. You violating the code, man.
I'm a rule breaker, man. I'm like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jerry's a fascist.
You one of them end times dudes.
Not this week, Bruce, damn it.
You eat your dog, you eat your friends.
I mean,
yeah. Don't be trapped nowhere with him at the last.
Hey, don't worry, guys. Last minute. Don't worry, guys. I like dark meat.
Oh, I'm the first one to go. It's always the brother catching it first. And I'm out. Man,
put this red shirt on.
I had no idea you were that old. Look pretty tender to me.
Put that red shirt on. Go outside the cave. Like, what? That motherfucker don't.
He won't be back at next episode.
He ain't never coming back.
Oh, all right. Yeah. Thanks everybody on Facebook Live for watching. Thanks everybody listening on iTunes and Stitcher. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, you can always go to kyhbb.com and find links to all our social media, our YouTube. Speaking of YouTube, like and subscribe. Definitely do that. I know if you guys are watching now, you're probably not going to go back and watch it again, but share it with a friend. It'll be up later. So without further ado, I'm your host, Jerry Saylor.
I'm Leffer Slope and Dusty B.
And I'm Bruce Leonard.
I'm Tyrone Devu.
We the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
Fuck you, Toby.
You threw me off with that Devu.
Yeah. It's late night.